Hello. Welcome or welcome back to Capital Recreations. My name is Shlomo. In this video, I will be describing and demonstrating the exercises which we'll be doing in our Zoom session for Wednesday, January 27th. If you would like to participate in our Zoom sessions, feel free to use the contact link in the description below. You can also find the list which I'll be describing, the list of the exercises which I'll be describing also in the description below. All right, so here we go. The workout is a circuit workout, a total of 9 exercises. If you're doing this on your own at home or wherever you may be, you could complete each exercise for a total of 45 seconds and then give yourself no longer than 15 seconds rest between each exercise. At the end of each circuit, give yourself 60 seconds to recover and get ready for the next round. I would suggest do 3, 4, 5 rounds. Now, if 3 rounds are too much, aim for 2. If 2 is too much, just try for 1 or just 1 or 2 exercises. Whatever you have time for, make that time. You got this. All right, so here are the exercises. We're gonna do a plank. We're gonna do a triangle crunch on one side and then a pulsing bridge. Back to your triangle crunch on the other side. You're then gonna get flutter kicks, followed by shoulder taps, renegade rows. You're then gonna get suitcase deadlifts, and then squat thrusters, okay? You're gonna complete each exercise again for 45 seconds. Give yourself no longer than 15 seconds rest. Use your own body weight, use weights, whatever works. I'll be demonstrating the exercises right now, so let's do this. So, our first exercise is the plank, either on your palms or forearms. For this one, I'll be demonstrating on my forearms. I start off in a rested position, elbows under my shoulders. Toes are flexed in, and then I'm gonna engage, bring my torso off the floor, and hold. Hold steady, hold strong. You're gonna hold it for your designated amount of time of 45 seconds. 45 seconds is too much. Hold it for however long you can hold it. And there we go. Okay, next movement is your triangle crunch. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to get onto my side, left elbow underneath my left shoulder. I'm gonna flex both knees, bringing my knees forward, my heels back. My top foot is fully extended. Bring my hips off the floor so I have a space between my hip and the floor. I'm bring my top hand over the top, reaching. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to meet my knee to elbow, fully extended. Now if that's too much, you can always rest your foot on the floor. Complete your sets, complete your reps. And there you go. You're then gonna bring it onto your back into a pulsing bridge. You're gonna lay down, bring your heels underneath your knees, toes are pointed up towards the ceiling, hands are on your side. You're then going to press your weight through your heels, thrusting your hips up, getting a straight line from knees all the way to shoulders. Once you're holding here for about 3, 4, 5 seconds, you're then gonna start pulsing by resting and pressing back up. And there you go. We're gonna now go into the triangle crunch on the other side. So now, before I was on my left side, now I'm gonna be on my right side. Again, I'm gonna stack my feet, elbows underneath my shoulder. I'm gonna flex my knees, bring my knees forward, extend the top leg, rest it on the floor. Take my top hand, reach it over my head. Now, get the space between my hips and the floor. Bring my side of my foot off the floor, fully extended on the upper from my fingers all the way through my toes. Then I'm gonna crunch my top elbow to knee. And exhaling as you bring each one in, and there you go. You're then going to rest and go onto your back into flutter kicks. I know we did flutter kicks in some previous exercises, some previous workouts, but here we go again. Bring your hands underneath your glutes or at your side. Bring both heels off the floor. Flutter your feet from heels to toes. And there you go. We're going to continue right through. Shoulder taps onto your front side, onto your palms, bringing your hands together in a triangle position. So your hands, your thumbs meet on your mat. Step your right foot back wide. Step your left foot back wide. Hold one, hold two. Take your right hand, bring it up to your left shoulder. Take your left hand and then return back to the floor. Then you take your left hand, reach it up to your right shoulder, return to floor. Slow and controlled. We want to stay steady. We want to stay strong. There's no swaying. There's no rocking. You can always drop to your knees and make this easier. All right. From here, we've done a number of exercises on the floor. We're going to stand up and we're going to do an upright row. You're going to take your weights or just body weight, palms facing your shoulders, feet underneath you, shoulder blades back. You're then going to pull the weights up the front of your body, following your elbows from your quads to basically your armpit section. Pulling up and pulling back. There you go. All right, into our next movement. After our upright row, we've got our suitcase deadlifts. You take your weights, put them in your hands, okay? And then you're gonna do, imagine you're doing a squat. It's basically a squat with weights at your side. And then finally, you're gonna bring the weights up in front of your shoulders, squat back, and add in a press for a squat thruster. Sitting your hips back, exhaling and pressing, do your sets, do your reps. Awesome. That is our workout for Wednesday, January 27th. I hope to see you there. Till then, peace.